WBUR Podcasts, Boston.
Hey, it's Daryl. Team Common is currently working on our transition to a weekly show. We'll be back this summer with new episodes. In the meantime, here's one from our archives. I'm Daryl C. Murphy, and you're listening to The Common. The beginning of September is the unofficial moving season here in Boston. I even moved here on the first 2 years ago, and it was quite hectic. Driving a U-Haul through a new city, the traffic congestion, the search for parking, then unloading. So congrats on your new place. You did it. I hope the move wasn't too bad. Now, you're probably thinking of ways to make your place feel like home. Your home. And a great way to do that is by adding some plants to the space. But that can be a challenge, especially if you don't have a green thumb or you live somewhere with low light. That's why for this episode, we're at Emerald City Plant Shop, the first Black-owned plant shop in New England. We drove down to Norwood to talk with owner Quante Turner. Q, what's happening? Oh, Quante, excuse me. Should I go Quante or Q?
Excuse me. I really don't have a preference.
Quante, who also goes by Q, opened Emerald City more than 2 years ago. But plants were a part of her life long before that. So I wanted to learn more about what people like you and I can do to bring more life into our indoor spaces and what brought her into this business. We take a seat inside the shop surrounded by beautiful plants and art. It doesn't feel like a place where you go in, buy something, and leave. It feels like somewhere you can just chill for a bit. I'm looking at, feeling the vibe in here. Like, I know what it is. I feel very comfortable in here.
So you know what I mean? The shop was modeled after my living room, my house. Because I would just have it be filled with plants, and plants would always be dying, and I'd be getting new ones, and they'd be growing. And so when I saw the space, when I stumbled upon the shop, I was like, oh, this is just a big plant living room that could turn over to be whatever you need it to be. So very intentional about having like furniture that collapses into each other, you know, merging art. So everything in Emerald City is designed to be recycled, reused, to like go back to the earth.
Yeah. I want to ask you about what made you decide to get into plants specifically. What is it about plants?
I got into plants when I stopped traveling for work when I was an admissions counselor back in 2017. Mm-hmm. It's because when you're on the road all the time, you can't care for anything living. So when I stopped traveling, my nana gave me two plants, a clipping of her pothos and her spider plant. Okay. The spider plant is no longer with us, but the pothos is still alive and well.
Of course.
yep, of course it is. I was into plants kind of before the pandemic, and I, you know, took a part-time job in my entrepreneurial journey working at a plant shop, which expedited my love and interest and knowledge of plants. Mm-hmm. And so there was a pop-up opportunity in December of 2020 at Legacy Place down the street from where I am. And there's no plant shop in this area aside from like Home Depot, and, you know, you can buy plants anywhere, but in terms of a specialty shop, there's none except for going into Boston or going all the way to Providence. So I was like, well, let me take this month pop-up to do plants. And I did, and I sold out every weekend. And I was like, I guess there is a market for plants. And so I kid you not, 2 weeks later, I was running errands, and I parked right in front of the vacant storefront that is now Emerald City. I started a GoFundMe, and by the time we opened May 1st of 2021, we had fundraised about, I think it was like about $16,000 to open. So like I hung these ceiling tiles, my friends helped me in some aspects, we got a lot of the furniture donated, and that's how we started, and I've just slowly been building on it.
Oh man, did you know that you were going to be known as the first Black-owned.
First Black-owned plant shop in New England. Yeah, like now, not only, now there are others. I mean, it's not, for something that is so innate for Black people and Indigenous people and people that are connected to the land for centuries, right? We're not represented commercially in plants, really. And now it's kind of starting to change. But everyone I know, like, either has gotten their plant gene from their nana or their mother.
I automatically think about my mother. I think about my grandmother. Mm-hmm. They had gardens, you know. So, and whenever I have plant questions, I'm calling my mom, you know. Like, mm-hmm.
From Our Mother's Gardens is a great documentary on Netflix I recommend.
I want to talk about, you know, you're a Mattapan native.
Yes. Yep.
Yeah, talk to me about growing up in Mattapan and how you bring that to your work at Emerald City.
I love Mattapan. I grew up on Elmont Street and then moved to Rosemont Street in high school. And so to even see how it looks now, it's so different, yet it's still so the same. Like, the very, you know, real stereotype of Mattapan is it's AKA Murderpan. Like, I have a lot of classmates that were lost to gun violence. Even any way I can find a way to give back, I do. So every year we do a free plant giveaway to give out plants to the community because plants bring joy. We did it this year, and one person sent me a message. She was like, all of my income goes to my rent. And like, I don't have anything else. So this just was able to bring me so much joy to be able to have plants without necessarily having to pay for them.
Sharing clippings with people, giving people plants, right? That's a way to build community, right? Mm-hmm. You know, and you're sharing that joy with them by, you don't have a plant? Okay, snip. Now you do. Which brings me to my next question. How has plant care taught you about caring for yourself?
My favorite question. There's so many life lessons that plants teach us if we're caring for them, right? Everybody is worried about like, oh, well, what's the schedule in which I water it on? Like, it changes by the seasons, and everything changes by the seasons. Like, you aren't the same person you was 5 minutes ago, let alone 10 years from now. And so how do you nurture yourself? So plants teach us about life. And when I explain plant care to people, where you want to put your plant might not be where your plant thrives. And so looking at yourself, like, are you in a place that you're thriving? Like, you know, so they kind of flip the mirror back on us if you kind of listen. And so that's my whole goal, is to get people to, like, connect. And plants, like, literally just tell you to, like, chill out.
We're going to take a quick break, but we'll be right back.
Electricity, a big idea that's inspired countless new ones. From powering the light bulb to virtually powering our entire lives. 30 years ago, State Street launched the Spider S&P 500 ETF, SPY. A big idea that inspired the world to invest differently. And still does. What can you do with SPY?
Before investing, consider the fund's investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses. Visit SSGA.com for a prospectus containing this and other information. Read it carefully before investing. SPY is subject to risks similar to those of stocks. All ETFs are subject to risk, including possible loss of principal. Alps Distributors, Inc. Distributor.
Politics has never been stranger or more online, which is why the politics team at Wired is making a new show, Wired Politics Lab. It's all about how to navigate the endless stream of news and information and what to look out for. Each week on the show, we'll dig into far-right platforms, AI chatbots, influencer campaigns, and so much more. Wired Politics Lab launches Thursday, April 11th. Follow the show wherever you get your podcasts.
Now that we know more about Q and how the shop came to be, it's time to get into some tips about plant care, because they don't stay green and healthy on their own. What are some of the benefits of bringing plants into your home?
Some of the benefits of bringing plants into your home is, one, like, it just changes and transforms the space. Like, I look at a spot that doesn't have plants and it looks very dead and dry, and then you look at it and it's living decor. You don't have to do much else when you have lots of greenery, but it filters the air. The more plants you have, the fresher the air is, because they turn over that CO2 and make it fresh oxygen for us. Just hearing people breathe deeper in here is worth it. And I think it reminds you to kind of breathe. Being around plants is like, oh, it's like, there's life here. And then just for your mental benefits, just stimulates creativity. There's like so many things.
That's perfect because we're at a time now where people are moving into their apartments, some who are new to the city. If somebody wants to get into plants, where should they start?
Snake plants. Snake plants, I always say, is your starter one. ZZ plants too, but always come with the caution of ZZ plants. They're extremely toxic to pets. So snake plants and ZZ plants like to be left alone. They like a little neglect. I've had people that said, oh yeah, I water my snake plant every like 2 months and it's like fine. It is the closest thing to an ornamental plant by being a real plant that you can get. Okay. So, and it does well in almost no light. It does well in fluorescent light and bright light. So it's really great for any dorm room situation or like basement apartment, or I'm looking at someone else's wall on the outside of my window. So a great versatile plant.
Excellent. Now, we're also in the Boston region, which can be quite pricey. What are some tips you have for people who want to get into plants, but they're on a budget?
So the beauty about plants is that having one, you can multiply and have many plants. So pothos, they grow vines and you can snip and clip. We actually have a community propagation wall at the shop, and also will be on Diana, our mobile plant trailer. So we're always like gifting people clippings to just start their plant journey. And also just the, you know, the act of like caring for something and watching it grow is just super rewarding. And so look for clippings of plants, but also, you know, come visit us, come visit. And if there's a lot of people will ask like, oh, I don't want to get my plants from Home Depot. You can get your plants from big box stores. Just be mindful. And we teach people about like pests and isolation and quarantining and, you know, treating your plants well coming in. So even if you don't get a plant from us, we can help you take care of it.
Awesome. And lighting issues. A lot of places do not have great light.
So no matter what, the closer your plant is to a window, the more light it actually gets, regardless of the positioning is. So put your plants closer to the windows to increase their light exposure. But if you have really splotchy light, grow lights are a great solution. And grow lights, you can get that look like daylight lights. I actually love grow lights because I feel like the same spectrum that plants grow under is the same spectrum that makes us feel alive, right? So I always say, you know, grow lights help me during seasonal depression because it feels like it's still light out. I have my plant lights on timers, and you can buy a grow light to plug into like a desk lamp. Like, it doesn't need to be any grand, big investment. We actually sell grow lights here at the shop for $15.
So Quante, you've been in Norwood and Emerald City Plant Shop for more than 2 years now.
Yes.
What are your plans and hopes for the future?
So we just got Diana, affectionately named after my Nana, our new plant trailer. So we have a pop-up plant trailer that's now on the road. And so just the opportunity and possibilities of being able to rent her out for people that, you know, want to try their hand at selling at a market, or want to rent her out for weddings or festivals. So putting Diana on the road to kind of make our operations mobile so we can reach more people with plants and kind of bring the magic that is in the shop on the road. So I'm really excited to see what chapter and journeys and adventures that brings.
Well, with that, Quante, Q, thank you so much for inviting us into your shop, giving us a tour, giving us some advice, and sitting down and talking with us here at The Common. We really, really appreciate it.
Thank you guys so much for coming. This has been awesome.
That was the owner of Emerald City Plant Shop, Quante Turner. You can learn more about Emerald City and what they're up to at emeraldcityplantshop.com. They're also on Instagram at Emerald City Plant Shop. And that's our show for today. Thank you so much for listening to The Common. If you like what you're hearing, please go to wherever you listen to podcasts, rate and review us, especially on Apple or Spotify. We would really, really, really appreciate it. Thank you ahead of time. Also, if you want to get in touch with us, maybe you got some tips for plant care, hit us up on Instagram at WBURthecommon or send us an email at thecommon@wbur.org. I'm Daryl C. Murphy, and I'll talk to you soon.